Hey guys, this is Dr. Sangeeta and welcome back to another lecture of Dental Paathshala where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy way. And today's topic is local anesthesia. So today's topic we are going to talk about the local anesthesia. So without further ado, let's get started. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss any of my future videos. So before talking about the mechanism of action of LA, we should be familiar with the action potential. What is action potential? Now we have, this is the sensory neuron. Sensory neuron is the neuron which is taking impulses, right? From the peripheries, like if I feel hot, then it will be taking impulses from here and going back to the central nervous system and telling that brain that I touched hot, or telling the brain that I pricked something. So this is the stimulus which the sensory fibers give. So these are the afferent fibers, and if we look at the nerve terminal of the sensory fiber, then what happens? There are the sodium gated channel, right? So there are sodium gated channel all around. So what happens whenever there is an impulse, whenever there is a touch, pain, temperature, any proprioceptive impulses? In the normal state, there are a lot of potassium inside and a lot of sodium outside. So the potential, the resting membrane potential, it has a voltage of, so RMP, the voltage, resting membrane potential of minus 80 millivolt. So this is the resting. When a nerve terminal is at rest, this much is the voltage difference. So we have two kind of channels. One are the voltage gated channel, another one are the ligand channels. This we have covered in the physio, so you can also find in the playlist. So we have voltage gated channel, ligand gated channel are basically the channel which opens by ACH. So acetylcholine, by neuroreceptors, neurotransmitters, I must say. So voltage gated channel are due to the electrochemical gradient. So what happens when there is a conduction? So these sodium gated channel, they opens. So when the sodium gated channel opens, there is a lot of sodium will start coming inside. So when these gated channels opens, so that sodium potassium pump also, I guess I have covered in the physio lecture. So these channel opens and the sodium start coming inside. What happens when the sodium start coming inside? Then this motor end plate potential, we can say, because there is the threshold potential. See, whenever there is a little bit of sodium which is outside, it is coming inside. So initially this threshold increases and then again it comes back. So some of the sodium comes in and then these channels stop. So what happens when there is lot of prick, or when there is lot of pain sensation, when there is a lot of stimulus? So when the stimulus strength is more, then this sodium, they keep on coming inside. So these threshold, or we can say mechanical sensitive channel. So we have the sensitive channels which respond to the mechanical receptors. So it can be the touch, pain, temperature, like that. So touch, basically the pain and the pressure. So all these mechanical sodium gated channel opens, and when these channel open, the threshold potential, it reaches up high. So this is, we call it the wave of depolarization, when lot of sodium comes in. Now what happens when lot of sodium comes in? There is a wave of depolarization. Then also these calcium channels are open also there. So calcium also starts coming inside. And when calcium channels also they open, then there is a lot of ACH release. So acetylcholine, which is formed at the nerve terminal. Now choline, which is coming from the outside, and acetyl, which is consumed from the mitochondria. So both of these, they combine to form the acetylcholine. And these, they have, see, at the nerve terminal, we have receptors, the calcium receptors for ACH. So basically these are the calcium binding protein. So these ACH receptors, they bind to this calcium binding protein and they get released outside. So this is how the ACH is released at the nerve terminal, and on the other side there are also the sodium gated channels are there. Now these sodium gated channels are not voltage channel, these are the ligand channel first. So on the ACH response they opens, and then again this is how from one side, from one nerve terminal to another nerve terminal, one to another, like that the impulses are transferred. So this is what we are talking about in the local anesthesia. Now what happens, these sodium gated channels, LA block these two sodium gated channel. So when this LA block this sodium gated channel, it blocks from outside also, inside also. So we will be talking about the theories, what happens exactly. So once this channels are blocked, then no impulse is coming. When no impulse is coming, no pain sensation. So if you are feeling pain here, now when I am pricking and when these channels are stopped, they are not responding. There is no transfer of pain to central nervous system. Then we don't feel the pain impulse. This is the effect of local anesthesia. So guys, these local anesthesia, they block the sodium channel reversibly. They are not blocking irreversibly. So after the effect is gone, again the sodium gated channel can, sodium gated channel voltage, sodium gated voltage channel I must say. So these sodium gated voltage channel, again they can open and the pain impulse can start. And this is the reason that after doing any extraction under LA, we prescribe the patient NSAIDs. We prescribe the patient analgesia, because after the anesthetic effect is gone, then the again the nerve will be conducting pain normal and the patient will again feel the pain. Now there is the main thing which you should understand before starting with the local anesthesia. Now you must be telling, ma'am, you have already covered in the 5 minutes, but there is lot more to come. So there are two things. One is the anesthesia, one is the analgesia. So analgesia is when already pain stimulus is there. See, when the patient comes to you, when already a pain stimulus is there, then you give painkiller, right? You don't give local anesthesia. So this is the difference between anesthesia and analgesia. So analgesia is when patient is already having pain. So you stop this pain stimulus is the analgesia. Anesthesia is before the pain stimulus, you are blocking this receptor. So you are blocking the sodium voltage gated channel in order to stop the pain. So this local anesthesia can be of two types, that we will cover in the classification. So starting with the anesthesia. Now anesthesia can be of two types again. Anesthesia, it can be local or it can be general anesthesia. So local anesthesia is when we are talking about the local area. So when we are blocking these sodium receptors on a local area, so that is the local anesthesia. General anesthesia is when you are talking about the whole body. So it is like if you are making ISD call, or if you are making STD call, so that will be a general anesthesia. While you are doing some major surgery or any organ transplant, then you require general anesthesia. Local anesthesia is which we do for extraction, which we do for the dental procedure. So any minor procedure wherein we want the reversible blockage of the sodium gated channel, where we want the local numbness, is we use the local anesthesia. Or you can use for suturing. If any kid falls and if suture is required, then also it is given under local anesthesia. Stitches or any nail surgery, it is also done under local anesthesia. So basically the mechanism of action of local anesthesia is that the sensory fibers which are taking impulses to the brain. So these fibers have sodium gated channel. So these sodium gated channels are blocked by local anesthesia. You must be asking, ma'am, how? How does it happen? We want to know more. But before that, let me tell you, cocaine, as you have heard of cocaine, the drug addict, all those movies, is actually the first local anesthesia to be discovered. And it is discovered, it is a natural product, and it is discovered from cocoa shrub. Now, Naaman is the scientist who find it, this cocaine first to use as the in the medicine. But Karl Kohler, he used it in the clinical practice for the first time. So now coming back to again the same topic, how this LA, it blocks the sodium channels. Now this local anesthesia is basically a weak base. So I'll be just writing B as a weak base, right? So B means, can you see any ion on B? No. That means it is unionized. That means there are no ions. There are two things, right? So if I write calcium, it will be like this. If I write Ca++, that is the ionic form. So like that, it is a weak base, which is a weak base under the pH of 8 to 9. So it is a weak base. So when it is a weak base, it is basically in an unionized form. When it is unionized form, so if you remember the cell membrane, that I have covered in the physio videos. So if you remember the cell membrane, now this cell membrane is composed of phospholipid bilayer. If you remember, this phospholipid bilayer, because this is a two layers of lipid, right? So it is made up of fatty acids and phospholipid bilayer. So basically this is all fats we are talking about. If you are trying to dissolve ghee or any fat in the water, are you able to dissolve? No. So this cell membrane is basically made up of, cell membrane we are talking about, we are not talking about the whole cell, we are just talking about the membrane. See, the cell membrane, the membrane of the cell is made up of fats. So if any fatty thing is there, that is going to easily, they are going to easily permit the whole content inside. So any fat soluble thing is going to get inside very easily. First is one thing you have to remember. Second thing is that because this is unionized, it is neutral. It is not saying that I am, what I am, it is not revealing its nature. So you can just remember this, that because it is an unionized form, it can easily penetrate the cell membrane. As it can easily penetrate the cell membrane, because it can enter the cell membrane at the faster rate. So it is faster, more faster. When it's come inside the cell membrane, now we have H ions in the cell membrane, inside the cell. So once we have H ion inside the cell, it combines with the H ion and it forms the ionic form. Now this weak base is in ionic form. Once it is in ionic form, it is lethargy. It doesn't want to do anything. So it is, when it get converted from anionic form to ionic form, first of all, after ionization, there is a formation of functional amide group. So there is a formation of functional amide group. Okay. At least one functional amide group will be there. So what happens when it is in unionized, it is not going to move anywhere. It is not going to cross any cell. It will be inside this cell. So this is how it enters the cell and how it works. So there are channels, there are voltage gated sodium channels. So there are two opens to this channel. And when the penetration is happening, whenever a transportation is happening, whenever anything is entering the cell, then both of these channels should be open. If one is closed, suppose if I close this, this is the common sense. Suppose if I close this gate, so will sodium be able to come inside? No, because this gate is closed, it will get stuck here. And suppose if outside gate is closed, then also it won't be able to enter. So if one of the gate is closed, so the outside gate, which is the M gate, or which we say the mouth gate. So mouth gate is like, which is present outside, you can remember, M gate. If M gate is closed, then also the sodium cannot come inside. Or if the halt gate is closed, then also sodium cannot come inside, right? So if any of the gate is closed, now what happens? Because this H, see, because this ionic form is present inside, it is going to go and block this gate. So not more, now no more sodium can come inside. When no more sodium can come inside, then there is going to be no transportation. Then there are going to be blockage of the sodium voltage gated channel. Then the impulse stop. When the impulse stop, pain stops. So this is how the sodium gated channel is slowing the depolarization. This local anesthesia is slowing the depolarization. So this depolarization potential, the voltage is now less compared to normal when it was like this. So this is how this local anesthesia works. So this was the baby talk. Now let's talk about mature adults. See, there are A delta fibers, C fibers, A delta fiber, which are the slow fibers. Then we have the C fibers, like that we have many fibers, right? So if you are following our videos, you know that C fibers are unmyelinated fibers. C fiber are basically the small fibers. And if we talk about the endo, we have covered A delta and C fibers. So A delta fibers are the fibers which are taking from the peripheries, which are taking impulses to the brain, to the CNS, brain and spinal cord, and it is taking the impulses of pain as well as pain, temperature, right? So the impulses of pain and temperature. Then we have, so let's just write it. So the first thing, the fastest conduction of the impulses is from which kind of nerve? It is from A delta fibers, which conduct the faster rate. Then the slow conduction is the C fibers. Now this local anesthesia, which nerve they affect more, which nerve they focus more? So they focus more on the myelinated, which is the covered. So myelin is basically a sheath which is present on the nerve, right? So these fibers, now you will be asking, ma'am, this nerve is wearing blanket. So how does it is going to affect this more, because it is so thick? Still, you are telling that this local anesthesia is going to enter into the sodium gated channel and going to close it. Now, I will tell you how this happens. There are nodes of Ranvier. That is my dad's name. So, there is the nodes of Ranvier. So, these nodes of Ranvier are present in the myelinated. Now, these nodes of Ranvier, actually, they have lots and lots of sodium gated channel. So these nodes of Ranvier have lot of sodium gated channel. Kitna? How much? So unmyelinated sheath have in a micrometer square surface, they have 35 sodium gated channel. Then the myelinated nerve have nodes of Ranvier have per micrometer square, they have 20,000 sodium gated channel. So can you see, in micrometer square part of nerve, this unmyelinated sheath has lots and lots of unmyelinated sheath of nodes of Ranvier have lots of sodium channel. So these sodium channel, because they have lot of sodium channel because of the nodes of Ranvier, so because of this reason that the local anesthesia, it enters faster rate in the myelinated sheath, right? In the fibers with the myelinated sheath. And as we know that A delta fibers are the nerve fibers which are myelinated and which are responsible for pain. So this is the reason that first thing which responds to local anesthesia is the effect of pain. So patient won't feel painful because this local anesthesia is first of all affecting more in the myelinated sheath if we compare with the unmyelinated. First thing is this. Second thing is that, see, there are comparison between small nerve fibers and large nerve fibers. So if you look at the small nerve fibers, small myelinated we are talking about, okay? Both are myelinated. We know that myelinated are, they are responding well and faster. So if we are talking about myelinated, in that we are talking about small and larger fibers. So if we are talking about these small fibers are actually blocked earlier. And if we are talking about larger nerve fibers, or we can say these greater diameter, it take longer time to anesthetize. So in order, if we talk about the B fibers, then we have the C fibers. These are the somatic sensory fibers which are taking signal from the periphery to the central nervous system. Then we have A delta fibers. As we know that A delta fibers are responsible for pain. So this is the reason, if you look at the order. So first thing, after giving LA, pain is not there. Then the second thing which diminishes is the temperature. So first is the temperature pain sensation, then the temperature sensation. Then we have A beta fibers. So A alpha fibers. So after A delta comes A alpha, then comes beta, then comes gamma fibers. So this A alpha fibers are responsible for the touch, or we can say the proprioception. Then A beta fibers, which are basically the proprioception fibers. So this is how these impulses. So these are touch. Then we have pressure, the proprioception. So the pain sensation goes first, because the pain sensation, the fibers, nerve fibers, which are taking the pain responses, which are taking the pain impulses, they take up fast. So this is the reason pain impulses are first impulses, which are the fibers which are affecting the kind of impulse is the pain impulse first. Then the temperature, then the touch, and then the pressure, or we can say proprioception. So this is the order of the sequence. Then we are going to talk about the sodium gated channel. If you remember, I have told that the weak base, which is unionized, is coming inside the cell membrane and getting ionized. Now once it is getting ionized, it is blocking the sodium gated channel from inside. So it is blocking from the Holt receptor. Either it can also block from the outside also. So when it is blocking from the outside, then it is, if you have heard of, after eating or after having a fish, there is sometimes a poisoning, which we say tetrodotoxin. So tetrodotoxin, TTA. So this tetrodotoxin, after having this fish, it blocks this poison, blocks the sodium gated channel from outside. From inside, we have our tertiary amine local anesthesia. And also we have some kind of receptors, you know, which are not based on these receptors, which are not based on these activation or the receptors. So this can be either the scorpion venom poisoning. So it is not blocking any of the receptors. It is not activating or deactivating any of the sodium receptors. So like that, these LA is working on, and that also we will cover in the theories of the pain, theories of the local anesthesia. So that we will cover. So this theory which we are talking about here in the mechanism of action is the specific receptor theory. So we have more theories which we will talk about in the next part of the video, which is the theories of the local anesthesia. I hope that you guys are clear with the mechanism of action. So basically it is blocking the sodium gated voltage channel. When it is blocking the sodium gated voltage channel, no more sodium is coming, no more action potential, no more wave of depolarization. So this is how this local anesthesia works. And this theory which we talked about is the specific receptor theory. So this theory is the specific, which is the most acceptable theory. Next video, we are going to talk about the theories of local anesthesia. So if you have enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up. If you enjoy watching and listening to me, then subscribe to my channel. What are you waiting for? And guys, if you are getting benefited from the videos, please do share with your friends. And stay safe, stay home, and take care, guys. See you soon.